Hi, this is Deborah Anderson, the Black Woman Animator. I wanted to show you in this video today how to use the bevel function and more importantly how to fix your bevels. I was in one of the forums and one of the guys was having trouble with some of his beveling and I was trying to display it with pictures but it wasn't really working out, so I wanted to create a video. I created this object so that we can speed up the process. Sometimes when people are creating their bevels, they'll use the insert edge loop tool and they'll go about it by putting them on the edges in this manner and creating this kind of boxed look. And that works for more simple models, but once your model gets a little bit more complicated, it's hard to route and reroute the edge loops. So we're just going to use the bevel function. So I go through selecting all of my edges that are involved in the bevel. So I'm going to do a ring selection. So I'm going to select this edge and then double click and it selects all the edges around there. I'm going to finish selecting all of these edges. I can actually deselect these edges because those aren't going to be involved in the bevel. And deselect this edge. And the ones on the top. I'm pressing down control to deselect. So let me make sure I have all the appropriate edges selected. Okay. So now I am going to go to Edit Mesh and Bevel. I just like to do the bevel. I don't like to set the functions before. So I'm going to go into the fraction, make it smaller. I like to use two segments. And so this is a pretty good bevel. I go to Object Mode. Select the object and press 3. You can see that in the corners, the smoothing is not quite right. So I'm going to show you my process for fixing this. Let me turn on wireframe on shaded. Okay. So let's press 1. And so what I do for all of my bevels is this quick technique that I learned when I was a 3D artist in South Korea. So I'm going to use the multi-cut tool. And so I start with this cut right here, and then I take it all the way to this corner. And the process that I'm doing right now, at the end of it, you come out with all quads. I'm a strong believer in trying to model with quads and as few triangles as possible. So my next cut, I start in this corner of the bevel, and I bring it down here, and then I used to go all the way down to this corner, but since I'll be deleting this edge right here, I recently started putting the cut higher. And then I'll press enter and do this on the other side and press enter, and then I go into edge mode and I always delete these particular edges. So these that create the triangle right here, and then this edge and this edge, because right here is going to flow into one edge. So if I go to Edit Mesh and delete edge and vertex, you can see that now my bevel should look better. So let's go to 3, and to see it better, you can see that it looks much better. And as you look right here, this is a quad, this right here is a quad, and then we have quads right here. So I'm going to show you the technique again on this side. So I'm going to use the multi-cut tool. I went to my shelf for that time. Go all the way to this corner. Do a cut right here. And a cut right here. Let's make sure I cut properly in this. Yes, I did. Then I go to edge mode. And then delete edge and vertex. The shortcut for that is control delete. And if we go into object mode, press 3. You see we fixed our bevel. Now that problem usually happens when the bevel flows this way. When you have the corners, when you have the bevel on a corner, it doesn't have that problem. So I just showed you my technique. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments. Thank you.